Hey guys, what's up? Roby here with another tutorial on WordPress and the Divi theme. That's the theme I'm using for this particular tutorial, and it's creating this awesome difference effect when you have some text that's kind of hard to read on a video background. It's a great tool to use, and you can kind of see how the white text dodges the dark parts of the background and vice versa to make sure that your text is easily legible. And it's a really great way to engage your users and people to visit your site. I'm going to show you two ways to do this because we're expanding the franchise. We want our WordPress users to also get the benefit from these Divi tutorials that we do. So I'll be showing you first how to do this in Divi, and then I'm going to be using Gutenberg blocks to do the exact same thing. Now, this is all born out of a code pen that I came across on a Reddit post, which I thought was very interesting. And I thought, well, you can do that with Divi, right? So without further ado, let's get right to it. Okay, guys, so what we're going to be working on today is this code pen that I found with what uses the difference filter or mixed blend mode to create this effect that when lighter things go over your light text, it inverts that color and makes it a lot more visible, which is an awesome effect, of course, to have for something like a header. This is a code pen by Jalen Burton, which I'll link in the description of this video, but it's a very cool effect. And this is going to be proof that you don't need a lot of code to do certain things in WordPress or Divi. It's very easy to do. So let's take a look at how we jump in and do that. Now, if you don't have a video file ready, of course, we have pixels to the rescue here. And I found this cool video of a motorbike dude going down the road. Sometimes with these videos, you can see that this video background has a lot of contrast. You might want to adjust that. So I use this tool called media.io. It's free. You just upload your video, adjust the contrast. I'm not going to show you how to do that, but it's super simple to do and pretty self-explanatory. Let's rock and roll. So like I said, this can be done on any WordPress site using any theme you want to. The implementation would just be a slightly different, but I'm using Divi today, so you can do it and follow along if you have Divi. I will show you how to add it in on just a plain WordPress site also a little bit later. So let's get to it right now. Okay, so here I've got a WordPress page. I just gave it this name. It doesn't really matter. And I'm just going to go ahead and enable the Divi builder. Okay, now if we don't get the double load, we're going to say build from scratch. And I'm not interested in a plain section. I'm just going to make mine a full width section and add a full width header immediately. We'll get to you in a second, Mr. Header, and just delete out that section that we're not using. I'm going to switch here to the visual builder mode. And now we can go in. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to design, layout, center my content, and make it full screen. Going back to my content here, I'm gonna go to text and I'm gonna give this a title and we will just say super big title. Now that's not very big yet, but we'll fix that in a second. And then for the subtitle, we'll go ahead and say, do it now, whatever that means. But there we are. I can also add a button in here if you would like to, and you can go say more stuff. I don't know, not that feeling that creative right now. So here we go. And I'm back on the design tab. Now, depending on the theme that you're using, this might look a little bit different depending on the builder that you're using, but this is all stuff you should know now. So I'm going to go to the text size. I'm going to make sure that it's nice and ultra bold. And then I'll probably make it something like 68. No, that's still too tiny. I'm going to make it 108. There we go. Finally did it. Okay, I've got my super big title there. And then for the subtitle, we're going to go into the subtitle text option here, ultra bold. And maybe for this one, we go with 88. There we go. And maybe we just give it a little bit of line spacing here. Not letter spacing, but line height. Increase that a bit just to give that a little bit of room. And I think we are done with the text part. Now we're going to go ahead and assign our background to the parent item here. So we are going to do it on the section and not on the actual full header module. And I'm going to go to background. I'm going to go to background video. And now you can go ahead and add your video. Now, I already made this video of the biker here going down the road dark. So I'm going to go ahead and select that and I'll upload it, technically already uploaded, and I will say all good. Now, I've got this background color here. Of course, that's because my full width header settings has a background color there, which I'll just delete. And now we can see our header. But as you can see, the problem here is that the text is not super visible. Now, of course, you can go ahead and add shadow and all sorts of other effects to this. but we're going to be using mixed blend nodes on this module. And you do that by just going to the design settings for the full width header module. And when you scroll down, you're going to go and find the filters section. Now within that, you keep going down, it's got blend modes. Now that is your mixed blend modes. And then all you got to do here is select difference. And immediately you can see that now the text is super visible. You've got this cool effect where everything can be seen. Now, if I go ahead and save this, and the text is not getting super lost. Now you can still go add shadow and stuff like that to it. I didn't do that here, but it's very easy to do. And there you go. Super simple, and shows you that you don't have to do a ton of different settings or write a bunch of CSS to do fun stuff in Divi, but we still need to look at how we do this in just WordPress. So let's go ahead and take a look at that right now, and let's go. All right, guys, so now we're going to do this using Gutenberg, and because I'm using Divi, of course, it's going to ask me, do I want to build with Divi, but I'm not gonna. We're just going to call this difference background, and all I did here was create a new page. And I'll just say, use the default editor. And then you'll see the Gutenberg block editor. Nice and easy. Okay, so first thing we're going to need to do is we're going to be adding a column in here. So let's just call this column and just make it 100% width. I do want to change some things here on the page itself. So the default template, I'm just going to make this blank. I don't want any navigation on there. You can do whatever you want. And then for the Divi settings, because I'm using Divi, I do need to shut off the sidebar because I want it to be nice and wide. And then what we're going to do next is we are going to go into our column here. And then here are all the different things you can set on the background colors, typography, and all that stuff. I'm not going to be messing with that. But what we're going to be putting in here is some text. So let me just type in paragraph is what I should have typed. But actually, let's go with heading. And then we'll just say fancy text background, whatever, just to demonstrate this to you. Cool. So I've got this here. I, of course, want to make my text white. That's going to make it disappear on the screen. So let's wait for that. And I want to increase the size here. So let's do it on 70 pixels. And we will center our text. So one step done. We've got our text that we want. Maybe to make this easier, I'm going to go on the column settings here. And for the design, I'm just going to give it a background of like this gray color. And then that way we can work with the text in the color that we want to use. Cool. We've got that in there. Element one complete. Next thing we're going to need to add here is a video. We will go and type in video. And then as you guessed it, we're just going to select that video that I have uploaded here already. And then just hit select. Now, very important here, you want to select autoplay, loop, muted, and deselect the play controls because it's going to be a background, right? You want this to run continuously in the background. You don't want it to make noise. Google doesn't like that. So there you go. And there we go. So let me save this and publish it. And then I want us to take a look at what this looks like on the front end because it's not going to do yet what we want it to do, but we're going to show the progression here. Okay, so now we've got a few things going on here. Our text is not in the middle here because, of course, Divi gives you this flexibility and the easy use of just adding the full width module, and then you can add all the text in there and stuff. And it also doesn't give you all the options for the blend mode. So let's go back here. And maybe the first thing we do is work with this text. We want the text to go to be kind of like in the middle of this video area. Now, how do we do that? That's not too hard to do. I am going to go here and add a class in the settings. I just need to close that out. So I'm here. I'm on the text module. If you expand advanced down here, we'll just call this a class called text-blend. No necessary period in the start. It already knows that because it's telling you to add classes. I'm going to go ahead and copy that. Now we do need to add another module here. So at the end of our text, let's just hit enter. And I'm going to hit /HTML to add a HTML block. And I'm adding CSS now, right? So I'm going to open up and close style tag. There we go. And then within that, now we need that period and the text blend class and an opening bracket and a closing bracket on the bottom. My formatting here is going to be terrible. Deal with it. It's not the end of the world. Now, the first thing we want to tell it is that, okay, we want this to be position absolute because that's going to make sure that it is static on the screen and it doesn't move around, right? So it's not going to be bound to the container. Next thing, I'm going to tell it, I want it to be a few pixels from the top. So we're going to say top, and let's go with 400 pixels right now. You can always adjust that. And let me just kind of fix my spacing here. And then let's go look on the front end what that's done. So we've got that saved up. Let's refresh this and boom, now our text is right here, kind of in the middle. I'm liking that. That's fine. Maybe let's just also center our text, but it's centered. Okay, great. So next step, what do we want to do? Well, maybe we just want to give it a bit of a heavier font weight. So all we would need to do here is come over here, appearance, and then we just call that bold, or if it has extra bold, let's go with that and update that. Okay, one part done. Now, the next part that we need to do is we need to give this video some properties. So we're going to go to the advanced settings on the video, and then we're also going to be adding a class, and I'll just call this video BG for background. And then that enables us to go and start adding some CSS. Now, this is CSS that I took from this pen, but it's pretty straightforward. I'll explain it as we go. So we're going to say dot video BG, which is that class we just added. Closing bracket. There we go. So first line we add. We want to set the height and the we want to set the height of the video, right? So we want it to be a full screen video. So we're going to go with height, and then we can go 100 vertical height. Now that's a setting. It knows how big the browser window is at that moment, and that's why it gets that number. So you don't have to calculate anything. It's with the magic of CSS. Now next up, we want to tell it, well, how do we want it to fit in that space? Easy enough. We want it to cover the entire container, and there'll be different options that you use for that, but that's the gist of it. Now also here, we're going to say, what position does it need to be? Well, it needs to be in the fixed position. Next is the left and right positioning. We're going to put it just snug in the corner and snug on the right, 0 pixels for both. You can do the same for top and bottom, of course, just to get the positioning more explicit. Now, if you find that weird things happen, you can go ahead and add the important operator, which will ensure that it doesn't bounce around, or if something gets overridden by your specific theme or whatever the case might be. Now, lastly, to make sure that this sits behind our actual text, we will give it a lower Z index of -1. Now, of course, Z index, as you already know, that's the layers. If you think Photoshop, how all those layers work, Z index determines what the arrangement of those layers are. So if we update this now, and we come back to our front end and refresh, now we've got a beautiful full screen video here that has some text that's hard to read. We're missing one line of CSS that is so easy to do. We'll come back on the back end here. And if you go here to the text blend class that we created, all you need to go ahead and do is put the following line of CSS, which is just typing mix dash blend dash mode colon. And then the mode here again is difference, which, you know, if you looked at the first part of the video where we do this with Divi, you just click a drop down and do it. But let's go ahead and update this. Hop on the front end, refresh, and there we go. We've got pretty much the same effect recreated. It was a little bit more PT to get this done, but as you can see, this is super simple to do. We just use some basic CSS to get this done. Divi, of course, makes that very easy, but I wanted to show you guys two ways to do this, and so that, you know, we can help some more people out with these Divi tips. So guys, that's gonna be it from me, from the Divi Engine crew. It's been Roby, it's been real. I'm gonna catch you in the next video. Oh, and before I go, don't you forget to like and subscribe to this channel to not miss out other WordPress and Divi tips coming straight to you from the Divi Engine team. All right, guys, thanks for your time. I'll catch you next time.